Now let's take a closer look at Glenn Beck's rally and its potential significance. Mark Amador is the political editor for The Atlantic and a CBS News political analyst, and he's in our Washington bureau for us right now. Mark, good morning.
Good morning.
Are you buying this whole it's a coincidence that on the 47th anniversary of the I Have a Dream speech, Glenn Beck is staging this rally?
It may have been a coincidence early on, but clearly I think it has turned into a deliberate attempt to change the meaning of the anniversary for the people who are there.
Let me ask you, as far as Glenn Beck is concerned, huge ratings on Fox News Channel, enjoys tremendous book sales and whatnot. Well, I mean, what's he trying to do here? What's his play? Is a potential political career in his future? What's going on here?
I don't think Glenn Beck will ever run for political office. I think he enjoys the power that he has. Just look, for example, at the gentleman in Nancy's piece who said, what Glenn Beck says, we will do. And Beck seems to understand that very well. And if you look at the arc of his show over the past year, it's been a series of prescriptions. Read this book, take this online course, don't read this book, don't listen to this person. He is, in essence, providing the intellectual ballast for the Tea Party movement. I think that sustains him, as well as you point out, the enormous profits he's generating from his books, from his online university and elsewhere.
Let me ask you about the turnout for this. What are you thinking?
Yeah.
You thinking 100,000, 200,000, 300,000?
Well, they're saying 300,000. That would be surprising if that were true. But even if it were 100,000, I think one point is this. These are mostly very conservative Republican voters. This election cycle, Democrats can't turn out anything nearly approaching 100,000 voters. That's one reason why it's so significant. All these conservatives in one place, a sign of how enthusiastic and energetic conservatives are heading into the midterm elections.
If you've got this massive turnout, does this kind of solidify his standing as an influential figure, a la like a Rush Limbaugh? Does it put him in that same pantheon?
I absolutely think it does. And in some ways, if you look at what Limbaugh was able to do in 1994 in terms of, in a sense, galvanizing and solidifying the Newt Gingrich revolution and spreading its ideas throughout the country, Beck has been able to do with the Tea Party movement, which I think existed in many ways before Glenn Beck. If Glenn Beck wasn't the avatar for this movement, somebody else would be, because there are independent conservatives out there genuinely angry, and Beck simply is the best person to give voice to them. He is a marvelous communicator.
Mark, I got to let you go there. Thanks so much for taking the time and joining us this morning. We do appreciate it.
My pleasure.